T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We have main engine ignition. 4, 3, 2, 1. And we have solid motor ignition and liftoff. Liftoff of America's space shuttle on its first mission, and we have cleared the tower.
Yes, it's liftoff. Only this mission will be controlled not in Houston or Cape Canaveral, but by a group of 12 to 14-year-old boys and girls from all over the nation who are having the experience of a lifetime. Space Camp at NASA's Space and Rocket Center in Huntsville, Alabama.
I want to be an astronaut when I grow up.
I want to be an astronaut when I grow up.
I'd like to be an astronaut also.
Yeah, I wanted to do something with space.
I kind of want to be an astronaut.
I've always had a dream of becoming an astronaut or a scientist. And I hope to fulfill that dream with, you know, starting young.
And starting young they do. It's a week of participating in much of the same activity done by NASA astronauts. Edward Buckby, director of the Space and Rocket Center in Huntsville, is the creator of Space Camp.
We try real hard to let the kid get involved. What we like to say, let you be the astronaut for a week. And hopefully generate some new engineers and new scientists for the future.
Divided into groups of about 10 each, they're assigned team names by planets and stars, and wear color visors that tell everyone which planet they're from. Okay. The week begins with learning about spacecrafts, rockets, propulsion, and guidance systems. This astronaut training is done by space counselors, experts from NASA and private industries, and occasionally from the kids themselves.
Saturn V, everybody knows what this is by now. Saturn V moon rocket carried men to the moon, as well as circling around the moon. Yeah, the Apollo missions deliver 7.5 million pounds of thrust with the first stage. And
doesn't it have four stages?
Three stages. It has three stages, yes.
Computer training with Plato gives the kids information on spaceflight, the growth of man flight, robots, lasers, and the power of rockets. They learn the requirements and training techniques to become an astronaut, beginning with a visit with Monkey Knot Baker. In 1959, Miss Baker made a rocket flight 300 miles above the Earth. And it was this flight that convinced scientists that they could send a man into space. Life support systems are essential, so campers get to try on spacesuits. No life support system is complete without astronaut space food. The kids have their own ideas about the food, though.
I don't really like it. I think everybody else does.
Altogether, it was pretty good.
The chicken and rice was all right, but that corn tastes like cardboard.
Next, it's a trip to the Marshall Flight Center, where astronauts train for the Skylab space station. NASA built a tank containing 1.4 million gallons of water. Astronauts discover working conditions of movement in water are similar to movement in an orbiting space station. And the campers get to meet men from the European Space Agency, preparing for flight aboard the space shuttle in 1983. A walk on Space Camp's lunar surface is the next best thing to being there. In fact, this lunar surface was designed by astronaut Neil Armstrong himself, with space footprints made by boots actually worn on the moon. Remember the moon buggy? The kids here refer to it as a space go-kart. Of course, the first training of astronauts begins with an awareness of gravity. And with the 1/6 gravity simulator, it's a moonwalk, or close to it, because the kids feel only 1/6 of their own body weight. This is the multi-axis chair, a 6-foot gyroscope with three rings attached to each other. It's a ride of a lifetime, spinning in three different directions at once. NASA says it prepared astronauts for the possibilities of falling in a weightless state.
Going upside down is just like you're flying all over the place. But it's better to do it in the dark because you can't see where you're going.
Okay, next step in training is the zero gravity machine, working with counterweights as the kids reach the arc of the big arm. For a split second, it creates the feeling of weightlessness.
And you can feel yourself lift up because you push yourself off, and that's how you go up. It's like bouncing in the zero gravity.
During the week at space camp, the kids have built their own 17-inch rockets, complete with a recovery system and parachute. The final day of space camp is the countdown. The kids become part of a mock shuttle mission from liftoff to touchdown. And for the kids, it's as close to the real thing as you can get.
Liftoff. We have liftoff.
I was born in 68, and in 69, Neil Armstrong landed on the moon, and, you know, was the first man on the moon. This is the best time for us to, for me to be born, because, see, everything's been happening, you know. This is when we really jumped into space.
The excitement of being in outer space and working with other people.
It makes me feel like an astronaut.
I'd like to explore different deep space exploration on different planets, outer planets, or start a new colony in space.
I'd say that a lot of stuff could be learned by exploring space, you know, like the origin of man, you know, the stars and all that, you know, what would happen, you know, because it's really interesting. It really is.
To visit other worlds, planets, and discover what space is all about. Adventure.
Yes, space is an adventure for these children of the 80s. Remember the faces of the kids you've seen over the past few minutes. They dream dreams many of us never knew existed. And it's from these dreams that man will travel into the far reaches of space. These are the children that will make those dreams of the future a reality. And who knows? Perhaps some of those dreams will be sparked right here at space camp.